Okay, so we talked about some of the proteins, and we just need to kind of go over what exactly do you guys need to know with the protein activities that we did. So the first thing we need to talk about is that there are different types of proteins that we're responsible for knowing. We have different types of proteins in our bodies. The first one is an enzyme, and enzymes control chemical reactions. So they are in charge of metabolism, breaking things down, and making sure that we have adequate nutrients and our body's able to use those nutrients. So there is a picture here just to give you some digestive rich enzyme foods. So you can kind of think about if you're making those choices, you're feeding your body exactly what it needs. The second thing we talked about is structural proteins, and these are the things that make up our bone, skin, hair, things like that. And this is just a picture of elastin, collagen right here, and you notice that the collagen is nice and firm in this nice structure, and then as you age, it starts to break down, which is what causes you to have aging skin. Signaling proteins, proteins that communicate with other parts of the body. They signal that, hey, we need to raise our temperature, lower our temperature. We need to release hormones. It just kind of gives us the map of what needs to happen. These are signaling proteins. And regulatory proteins control the production of proteins by blocking access of the information to in the DNA. So the regulatory proteins say we need more of this protein or we need less of this protein. And then there are certain disorders that occur because of buildup of proteins or lack of proteins. So these are super important because they control how the DNA is read. And then we have transport and carrier proteins, which were actually the first proteins that we talked about this year when we talked about the cell membrane and how things can get in and out and how important proteins are for that process. Okay, now. There are a couple of proteins that we talked about that we need to know. Now, we did a whole lot of proteins on the protein explorer. We only need to know a couple of them in detail, so I'm just going to go through those. First one is glucagon. So glucagon is a signaling protein. It causes the release of glucose into the bloodstream. Now, this is good because we need a certain amount of glucose in the bloodstream. If we get too little, we have low blood sugar. If we get too much, we have high blood sugar. And we need to have sugar in order to make ATP. Next one is insulin. Insulin is also a signaling protein, and it tells us to make glucose, and that's important in order for us to have proper working bodies. Again, glucagon and insulin work together to maintain the correct level of glucose in your body, and if you remember that word is homeostasis. And then diabetes is kind of a big thing in our culture, both juvenile diabetes and adult onset diabetes. So lots of us are familiar with how insulin works in order to kind of help correct that situation. Hemoglobin. Hemoglobin is a transport protein and allows red blood cells to carry oxygen. Okay, if it's missing, red blood cells can't carry oxygen. If you have deoxygenated blood, you have all kinds of problems, and that definitely can lead to death. If you have low hemoglobin, though, you still survive, but you might have a process or something called anemia, so you have to work on that. Human growth hormone. Human growth hormone is a signal hormone, and it is or signaling protein, and it is what tells our body to grow. It stimulates growth in young children and all the way through young adults. And if it's missing, you can end up with short stature along with a couple of other things. And it is controlled by the pituitary gland. And there are some synthetic treatments for human growth hormone deficiency, but they are not foolproof and, of course, have side effects as well. All right, lactase. So, probably we've heard about people being lactose intolerant. And that is probably because they have a condition that affects their lactase enzyme. It is an enzyme that breaks down the sugar in lactose. The sugar in lactase has to be broken down into glucose, which your body needs, right, to make ATP, and galactose. So if that is missing, then your body doesn't properly break that down. So So not only does it cause gas and discomfort and some things like that, but it also doesn't give your body the glucose that it needs. So, but that is a very common problem in our society. So we have lots of treatments for that one. All right, so those are the ones that you need to know. Please make sure that you make note of that. Maybe some index cards, study cards, or something of that nature before test time.